Hello guys, in this video I'll be explaining you the second very important concept of collision. In this concept it is the fact that when two similar bodies which are similar in shape, size, shape, size and mass, they collide elastically and obliquely with each other, and one of them is at rest initially. So they both move perpendicularly to each other after the collision. So this is the scenario in which you can see that there is a ball which is moving with some velocity u in this direction horizontally, and it collides with another ball which is similar to the first ball, and the second ball is at rest. They collide obliquely, and obliquely means that after collision and before collision they would be moving on the different lines. So this is the line of impact. This red one is the line of impact. And this is the velocity of the first ball. Now let us find out the components of the velocity along the line of impact and perpendicular to the line of impact. So this component u parallel, which is parallel to the line of impact, is u cos theta if I have assumed this angle as theta, and the component which is perpendicular to the line of impact u perpendicular is equal to u sin theta. So we know the previous concept, the concept number one, which says that if two bodies collides elastically and their masses are same, then their velocities on the line of impact gets interchanged. Now before collision, the second object was at rest and the first object was moving with velocity u parallel on the line of impact. So after collision, their velocity of line of impact will be interchanged, and there will be no effect on the perpendicular component of the velocity of the first object, and it would move with that component because there is no component of impulse which is acting perpendicular to the line of impact. Therefore, the velocity which is perpendicular to the line of impact would not be altered. So after collision, the line of impact components of velocities will get interchanged, and object B would be moving with velocity of u parallel, which is equal to u cos theta, and object A would be moving in the perpendicular direction to the line of impact with a velocity u perpendicular, which is equal to u sin theta. So obviously you can see that they both are moving perpendicular to each other, and this collision was elastic, as well as the masses of the balls were same, and one of the ball was initially at rest. So these three conditions should be fulfilled, then they will move perpendicular to each other. Thank you.